we're going to get started with the channel plate. The channel plate is going to require us to just do a couple little things in order to get the dimensions correct. So there's a few key concepts you need to understand before getting started with this one. First off, is this right here. We've got a 45 degree angle. We've been given the length of one of the legs as 0.125. So therefore we need to know, what is the length of the other leg? Well, our basic geometry rule that states when this is a 45 degree angle, this length is equal to this length. Alright, so it doesn't make any difference if it's 0.125 or 0.25. The lengths are going to be the same if it's a 45 degree angle. So we've been given a few pieces of information on this drawing, like over here. We weren't given this length, but I calculated the length or the distance right here because I took an inch and a half, subtract 1.25. That gives me this leg is 0.25. Because I know this is a 45 degree angle, that tells me that the other leg is also 0.25. So these are things that we have to be thinking about, and we have to really be in that kind of mind frame to calculate the unknown dimensions. So it's kind of like a puzzle. So that's just kind of go about it that way. So if you take the 0.375, subtract the 0.25, then that gives you the length for this leg. So a lot of times when people start this problem, they go, oh, there's too many dimensions on here, I don't know. Well, you do know it. You just have to do a little bit of math or understand basic geometry in order to calculate or come up with the missing value. So I'm going to put 0, 0 in this corner once again. I'm going to draw the two legs for this angle, and I'm going to work my way around. We'll get to this right here. Once we get over here, there's another missing dimension. It's going to take a little bit of work with a calculator just to calculate it. But let's go ahead and get started. So with a new drawing, I'm going to start over in the left-hand corner. You know, I'm going to turn off the grid just to make it a little bit easier for us to see. So I'm going to start at 0, 0. All right. My my ortho button is not on, but dynamic input is. So remember, dynamic input off, dynamic input on. So we'll see that box prompting us for the length of the line and the angle. With ortho on, that locks us down vertical and horizontal. So that's a great tool to get used to. So the dimension that we had to begin with was the 0.25. So I'm going to go 0.25 in the right direction and then start it over. I'm just going to zoom in a little bit. Remember, your scroll button on your mouse will allow you to zoom in and out. So type in 0.25. If you don't have the dynamic input on, make sure you put that on there. So then that way it can make it a little bit easier for you to draw. Now, reminder, as I'm clicking on this, the endpoint is popping up, so that is the object snap. If you do not have object snap on, your mouse will not automatically pick up that endpoint. So you need to make sure that you're keeping that object snap button turned on, so it's going to make your life a little bit easier. I just hit the escape button. I should have just hit the undo button, but there we go. I did it again. Let's turn object snap back on. Anytime you draw something and you mess up, you can always come over here and hit the undo button, and that will back out of the last line that you drew. Okay, so just that was the undo. So I've got that line. Looking at the drawing, we have the 1.25. We know that this is 0.25, so the next line is going to be 1 inch. And we, like we said before on this drawing here, we know that this is also going to be 0.25. So let's get back over there, 0.25, up 0.25, and then come back to your endpoint, and that's going to give us our angles. So we call these things construction lines. We can erase those construction lines when we're done with them. We don't need them anymore. So you can just erase. I just now used the erasing cross button. So remember when you're erasing, let me just back that up. When you're erasing, you can use the crossing window, okay, drag into your left. Any objects that crossing box goes over will erase. Okay, so that's what I did right there. Or you can click on erase and pick each one of them individual, the X will pop up. Oops, I hit the escape button. Remember, right mouse button brings up the last command. Alright, so I'm going to continue on with this problem. So my line going up, we discussed this already, is 0.375 subtract 0.25, and that gives me an eighth of an inch. Over 0.5, down, ooh, we don't know that length. So, looking at our problem, we've got an overall height of 0.375. Okay, so we know that that's 0.375. And let's look around for another piece of information. This one right here. So we know that that is 0.2. So what the length of this line is the difference between those two numbers. So that is 0.175. So I'm going to come down 0.175. All right, another line we don't know. This one's going to require just a little bit more calculating. So this one here, we don't know this length, but we have a bunch of information given to us in the horizontal direction. We know the overall length of that line is 1.5. Okay, we know, let's go in this order, we know the 0.5, this is a length. Okay, so we know we're going to subtract 0.5. All right, so now we're down to 1 inch. We're going to come over here. We know this little line right here is 0.125 because it's a 45-degree angle, and one of the lines was given to us already. So we are at 1 minus 0.125, and then we know this right here is 0.3, so we're going to subtract another 0.3, and that equals up to 0.575. So back over here to our drawing, 0.575. And I think, guys, that's the hardest part of the entire drawing, is looking around all of those dimensions and calculating. Did I mess that up? I'm going to erase. I'm going to hit undo because I don't know which way I went just now. Oops, no, not that much. I'll show you what I'm going to do here. Erase. I drew a line over top of a line. I drew a window that way. I could erase only the line that's there. So I meant to draw, so that's my line that's 0.575. I wanted to draw a line over 0.125 and up 0.125 because I'm creating that 45-degree angle. So I'm going to go back there. Using the crossing window, this time hit the delete button, and that will get rid of that. Alright, so that basically starts off this problem. I'm going to let you finish the rest of it. You've got a line or a dimension right here you're supposed to calculate. So you're going to calculate that the same way we did down here at the bottom. You're going to look at the overall length, subtract out what you know, and then you can calculate that missing line. The rest of them is going to be the same. This is a symmetrical part, so meaning that the top dimensions are the same at the bottom. So I think you can work that out on your own. Have fun!